Students, now let us understand how we can solve the first SOP in JavaScript. Now let us read the SOP first. The SOP says, that is skill oriented practical says, create a web page in HTML having a white background and two button objects. Now we have to create a form here and we have to put two buttons on the form. It should have a white background by default. So when you don't give any color, it is white. Write a code using JavaScript such that when a mouse is placed over the button object without clicking, the color of the background of the page should change every 500 milliseconds. It is milliseconds. There should at least be 7 different and visible distinct colors, background colors, excluding the default color. Means when I place the mouse over the button, one by one, the background color of the page should change and it should show me 7 distinct color. When the second button object is clicked, appropriate message should be displayed in the browser's status bar. Now, students, when you are going to do this practical, probably you should have a browser with a status bar. If you are using Google Chrome, you may not find the status bar over in that browser. So to do this practical, you all are going to use Internet Explorer as a browser where you will find a status bar with the browser. Then in this same practical, you are going to create another web page using JavaScript, where the background color changes automatically after every 500 seconds. This event must be triggered automatically after the page gets loaded into the browser. So, student, here one more code you are going to write in an exam, and that is you are going to write a code on onload event of the page. That means as soon as the page gets loaded in a browser, the same code what you have written for a click for a say mouse hover, same it should happen, that it should give me 7 distinct color. There should be at least 7 distinct color visible and distinct colors. When the page is unloaded, you must get a message when page gets unloaded. So we are going to put some alert message when the page gets unloaded here. So when I leave the page, when I click close button of my page window which is loaded in a browser, it should display me this message, because when I click close button, that is cross mark on my browser, it closes the page from the memory or from the window. So once the page is closed, the unload event automatically gets triggered over here, and then when the page is unloaded, the event should fire and give me an alert message. So students, let us prepare for the practical 1A, I will say, which is an event driven program with two buttons. Now let us write the code one by one. So I will start writing the code. I'm going here in a notepad. there are many editors, student, but when there is an exam, you should use only Notepad. Now, this is a HTML5 code, so I will write here exclamation mark doc type HTML. Then I will write here HTML head. And students, I am going to write some program over here. So I will write your title first. So I will write your 7 colors on mouse over and status bar message on click event. Then I will write here slash title and I will leave some space over here for coding. This title is extra. I'll remove that. Then I'll leave some space over here and then I'll close my head over here. Okay, now I need a form, students. So writing a code for form is what? I'll write your body. As I write body, thereafter I will write a code. I'll put some message on the page. 7 colors with mouse over event and status bar message with click event. Okay, now student, I'll close h1 over here because this title is going to reside on my page, and in body I have not given any color, so by default the page, when it is displayed with the two button, it will be a white page completely. Now let us go ahead and write a code for form. I'll write your form. Then I will create a button. Input type equal to button. Value, in this value, I will write a message which is definitely going to tell me what this mouse over event will do. So I will write here please click, and sorry, I'll please take mouse over and see the color change. I will write this here. Thereafter, I need to call an event which changes the color of the page on mouse over. So students, take care when you are writing this, you will say on mouse over. Writing this keyword, student, you are going to take care that you are going to write your on word with a small case. M should be in the upper case, O-U-S-E, other characters are in the lower case, and the over words, O will be on a upper case, and rest of the other characters will be on the lower case. If you don't write this name, capital or small case, in such a manner, the event will not be fired, and the command will go wrong. Now here, I will equate this with, I have a method window dot set. I'll maximize the screen. Window dot set timeout. Now see, when I'll write this window dot set timeout, now this is not dot here. I have put a comma by mistake while typing. I should put a dot over here, window dot set timeout, and then I should write a function call over here. In the bracket, I will write here C1 as a color change function, will be my first function, and I'll call this C1 after how many seconds? 500 milliseconds. Okay, so I will close now this, and my code is now going to get closed here. Fine. Now let us copy this same thing again so I can save my time, but I need to change my event. And in fact, some characters I will save. Input type button will be there. Now here I will write. Click and see message on status bar. Click and see message on status bar. Now here it was not a event which is on mouse over, it is on click. Same, but here I will write something like I needed to call a function which is known as show function. I don't require a time over here, so I will write here show open bracket close bracket. So whenever you write a function call, you should always write it in open bracket close bracket. See, the function names should be always enclosed in a double quotes here. Okay, so care has to be taken, dear students, ki these two things when you write, it will create a form and it will, now I am closing my form. Now I will close body here. So saying slash body, it will close my body of the page, and then it will close my HTML by slash HTML code. Now here I have prepared half the code. Now let us write a code in such a manner that I will test a module one by one. Okay, so what I will write here, script type equal to, I'll write here text slash JavaScript. Fine. Then sorry, I will write here function C1. Open bracket, close bracket. Here I declared my function. Then I will close here. And here I will write window dot set timeout. Here I will give a call to a C2 function. Now why I am giving this call to C2 function, dear students? I need the color should be changed after 500 milliseconds, because when C1 function is called, its color will be something. Now that color I need to decide here. So I will write here document dot bg color. Now here the document dot bg color is going to define the page is known as a document which is loaded right now with the form on a screen. Its background color I'm going to change, and I'm going to change it to say blue. So I'll write here blue, and thereafter, after 500 milliseconds, I'll call C2 function to change the color of the next page. Now I will end this. Okay, and I need another function which I have to write here, which is known as my show function. So I'll write here show function. Here I will say window dot status is equal to welcome to color change event driven program. Now student, if you like to put some other message, you can put the other message over here, we don't mind, but put a proper message which will be allowed in a class, what I will say. Now I want to test this module. Before testing this, I have written two functions and I will close this, end this here with slash script, and I need to test whether my function C1 works and my status bar works. Once my one color works, then I will put same functions copying for another 7 colors. Okay, so this is a way we should first prepare ourselves. I hope you may not be able to see the code. I will first prepare myself with this is the way I'll write two functions. One is show function and one is C1 function, and I will test my module. So I am saving it as save as. I'll put it on a desktop right now. I will say SOP1 JavaScript dot HTML. Okay, and save this file with all files. And it is coming into the folder, so I'll directly save this here. Fine. Now let us test whether I have thought and it is working fine. Let's go to JavaScript. Then I'll search my program. So I should get my program first. Maybe it is somewhere here. SOP1 JavaScript. Okay. I'll just check where I have saved this. In this folder only. Okay, so let's go back. I'll go to JavaScript and I'll search for SOP1. So I'll put S over here. Okay, this is that SOP. Let's double click this. I have clicked already, but not coming up. Let me check. It should get loaded. See, two times I got it clicked. So I'll be closing the event. Now see, I can see two buttons and the color is being changed here. So what I will do, I will close this, I will right click this, I will say here open with, and I'll go to Internet Explorer because I was not able to find the browser over there. Now when you open it in a Internet Explorer browser, you may find that it allows you gives a warning that there is an ActiveX control and allow block content, it asks you. So I should allow here. If I don't allow, then my program will not work. Now I'll go and place my mouse over and the color is getting changed. Now here I can see a status bar. I click this and check whether the message is coming on Windows status bar. The message is not coming, so I need to verify the code. So I'll just go back and see the rectification about the code. I forgot a keyword here, function show, I should write. Now my first function was okay, so I will copy this function 7 times. Three, four, five, six, and 7. Now this function I will make C2 here. This function I'll make C3 here, C4 here, C5 here, C6 here, C7 here, and 7 distinct colors are there. Now every color is blue, so I'll write here yellow, I will write here green, I will write here red, I will write here orange, I will write here brown, I will write here pink. I will write here CN. So these are the colors. If I find a color is being repeated, I will change the color over there, whatever color I feel. There are 256 shade, you can find out the names of those colors and you can put the colors over here. So my this function is now will work. Okay, and now my program is ready, but when I will call here C2, C2 will call here C3. C3 function, see, C1 is duplicated, so I will remove this. Okay, I will make this C2, and instead of C, I will write here yellow. Okay, so my no color is repeated. This C1 will call C2, C2 will call C3, C3 will call C4, C4 will call C5, C5 will call C6, and C6 will call C7, and C7 will call C1. So every now and then the colors will automatically changed and it will come back to blue color, again green, then red, then orange, then brown, then pink, then yellow. These are the 7 distinct colors. The functions will go on. One function will call another function will call one more another function, and the color goes on changing every now and then as soon as the function call goes on. Now I hope The program is ready for launch. We'll save this program once again and let's go and execute the program. See, the page default color is white. Now as I put my mouse, it is changing the colors. This is with the browser Google Chrome. Okay, if I click, I won't be able to see the message here. Why? Because my browser does not contain a status bar. So what I should do, I should close this browser, close this program. I should go again here. I should not do the mistake when I am doing my practical exam. Go here, go to Internet Explorer. Here now, allow block content I will slay. The colors are changed. 7 distinct color, again blue, and it is every 500 milliseconds we are changing the color. Now click on this status bar, and can you see the status bar message right now appears? A silly mistake which I was doing was I was not writing the keyword function over here, and my program was not working. So don't be in a hurry. This is the first part of your SOP 1. We have completed only one practical, that is, we have come across a code for, you can say, a color change on mouse over, as well as on a click event, we are showing some message on a status bar. Now in my next lecture, you will see how to do the same SOP 1, but the second part. Thank you. If you like this code, subscribe my channel. Thank you very much.